How do I know if my ovulation is over?
That's the reason they sell ovulation tests by the six-pack, so you can track the hormone levels for a week.
That gets expensive. I do not want to use ovulation tests all the time.
Then you can tell when your fertile time is by tracking the cervical mucus.
I know it turns clear and watery on the day you ovulate.
That's true, and it is in contrast to the thick, white, gooey stuff you have the rest of the month.
So how can I tell my ovulation is over?
When the cervical mucus shifts from clear and watery to the consistency of lotion, a slippery off-white substance.
It has that consistency the day before ovulation too.
But after ovulation, it has the lotion-like consistency before shifting back to thick and white.
Do you have any advice that does not require something so gross?
It is not like I'm telling you to break out a microscope and study the crystals in the mucus too.
I never even heard of that one.
You could track your basal body temperature.
I've heard of women tracking their temperatures on charts to determine fertility.
The basal body temperature is your body's temperature at rest. It spikes the day after ovulation.
By how much?
It goes up around half a degree. However, you have to take care to do it right.
I know not to bother if I'm having a fever.
Being wrapped up in blankets, checking the temperature when you have been up and walking around, or using a thermometer without enough resolution can all cause you to miss the BBT spike.
How long does the temperature go up after ovulation?
It goes up for about a day after you ovulate, so yes, you could miss it if you check things one morning and then the afternoon of the next day.
That's why you're supposed to check the fertility measure the same time each day.
Some women develop breast pain or ovarian pain when they ovulate.
Fortunately, I am not part of that 20% of the population. And breast pain could be a pulled muscle and ovarian pain really gas or indigestion.
That's why people used cervical mucus and body temperature to track fertility. It is a lot harder to mistake for something else.
Peeing on an ovulation test is now sounding like the least disgusting option on this list.
It is also the hardest to mess up, given the control stripes on the test strips.